Hope everyone's having a good Wednesday. Got softball tonight, game one of the championship series against Texas. So do a watch along for that. Have a little fun there. But want to do a little football chatter before we get to later tonight. Obviously, we're inching closer and closer to our first SEC football season, and there'll be the big celebration on July 1st. And July is going to be a busy month with that, and hopefully some more recruiting good news, and also SEC Media Days we're officially taking part in this time. So that will be fun stuff. And we'll figure out some fun stuff to do for the month of June. But I want to talk about this because, you know, it seems like every week there's something new coming out. There's a new poll or ranking or whatever, and everyone's got their opinions, and everyone's kind of regurgitating a lot of the same stuff. And a lot of people, it's kind of been made pretty straight and plain towards us that Oklahoma, they don't think we're going to do well this year. They think we're a 7-8 win football team at the most. And listen, I actually respect the people who come out and say, OU's going to suck, their schedule's too hard, and I hate their offensive line, your quarterback, I don't trust them. I actually respect that you come out and have an opinion. So I think you're wrong. I think it's based on some other things, like those cute little Locked On Big 12 people or Baylor grads or whatever. They're adorable. But it's rooted in something at least. So I can at least point to is like, well, you know, you're just a hater. You're a longtime rival who's lost to us. So you're rooting for our demise. I respect that. There's honesty there. But then you get to like Jesse Simonson of On3, who about a month ago wrote a very, a little bit of a puff piece for OU. Basically things I've been saying and echoing for quite some time now, that, hey, Oklahoma's good enough to be a playoff spoiler, to get into this thing, the first 12-team playoff. They could possibly go 9-3. Maybe they win 10 games. You never know. He goes down the list of everything on this article. You know, he talks about there's like homework done. He talks about guys like Deion Burks. He goes deep into a running back room. Talks about Bill Beanbo's success. All these things, Danny Stutzman, Billy Bowman, talks about Dominic Williams, Caden Woolard. Like, there's actual homework done in this. And so it's like, okay, Jesse Simonton's a little bit of a believer. So when you write something like that, I think, well, if you've done that much homework and you say, hey, why can't they do this? But then you get into later in the next month, and then this is where I lose a little respect for Jesse. I still think he's a nice guy. I don't hate him or anything, but it goes back to this whole fence riding thing. It all kind of started when he did his little top 10 rating safety rooms or whatever, and OU didn't make the list despite having Billy Bowman in there, Peyton Bowen, and Robert Spears Jennings, and you know, playing the whole the five-star true freshman didn't make an impact last year, which if you watched a little bit of our games, he made somewhat of an impact. He is a true freshman, mind you. Peyton Bowen did make some block punts on special teams and forced a few turnovers. So to say he didn't make any impact is a little much, but a problem with Jesse is this. It's like, he then comes out with his list, so he's grading all of the over-unders for all the power teams. So he did the SEC, right? And there's you have the teams that are just right, or they're too high or too low on the Vegas over-unders. And so you go down the list, and Alabama's at a 9.5. He thinks that's just right. Auburn is a 7.5. That's right. Florida's at a 4.5. That's too low. Georgia's at 10.5. That's just right. Basically, you get to Oklahoma, 7.5 wins, that's just right. And here's where I have a problem with this. See, he opens up his discussion point on OU by calling back to his article he wrote a month ago. The Sooners have the makeup of a potential college football playoff spoiler, so he's already setting, defense mechanisms. You know, if Jackson Arnold does this, this, and that, say they could start 5-0, but then he goes back to the schedule, he goes back to the other teams, and it's like, hey, 7.5 is just right. So my problem with all that is, you write something like that a month ago, a nice little puff piece for Oklahoma, where it's like, hey, this is a potential playoff spoiler team. And you say they're at 7.5, and you say, that's just right. Is it really? Because if you actually believe some of the stuff you wrote a month ago, wouldn't 7.5 be low? Because in order to make this playoff, at bare minimum, you're going to have to win 9 games and win some of the right games. That's another thing we're hearing in the offseason. You got to win the right games, whatever those mean, because whatever you think the right games are going to be in the offseason might turn out to be the games that don't matter at all. Like, beating Tennessee might be more important than beating Alabama for all we know. You know, beating, you know, Ole Miss might be more important than beating LSU. So it all just kind of depends how the season, the ebbs and flows of week-to-week football in the fall. So it's irritating to me that a month ago you're saying, hey, this team could make the playoff. They could be a 9-3 or 10-2 team, and they could surprise everybody. Well, when you come back and say 7.5 over under is just right, it tells me you don't actually believe that. So I lose a little respect for guys like Jesse who do that, who play that game. So it's like, again, if you say we're gonna come out and suck, it's like we basically can go on the internet and have fights like this. Fuck you, man. Fuck you. No, fuck you. No, fuck you. No, I said fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Your mother. Oh. Okay, that got a little weird, but you get where I'm coming from on that stuff. So, anyway, just throwing in my two cents there on the whole riding the fence with certain, because nobody wants to be wrong anymore. Everyone wants to have, you know, their everyone wants to have like their parachute, or they want to have their safety net in case their prediction goes wrong. You have some people in the OU media or who are like that, who cover this team, who are like, as we said 6 months ago, y'all know who I'm talking about if you follow recruiting. It's just, I'd rather you have an opinion. Have an opinion. Like, the jobs of people like in this industry, whether it's like low level YouTubers like me or guys who are higher on the totem pole, is to garner a response. And some people are just straight up trolls. Some people make big predictions, big ones, they're right, wrong, whatever. That's the job of what you're supposed to do in this thing. Garner a response. My response is like, pick a side of the fence. You think they're going to do it, or you think you're not going to do it? I'll respect you more at the end of the day if you pick one side or the other. So, again, that's my two cents on this. See y'all later for softball tonight. Boomer Sooner, and catch y'all later.